Third crisis, in addition to the environmental and the social crisis, is the moral, spiritual crisis of people in affluent sections of the planet, like here, doing this. Huh? I don't see any crises. What are you talking about, Kevin? The bubblehead mentality. You know, the backward helmet. Turn the helmet around so you can see, baby. You're blind, right? But they're blinded, they're insulated by commodities. Somebody who lives in a nice house with a nice car and a nice stereo and a high-paying job and their kids go to a good school. Sure, of course. Of course you're not going to want to see, because if you see, it's like the position of the person who's high up in the Titanic and the Titanic's going down. Is it, what? You want me to be in solidarity with those people down in steerage? I'm getting in the lifeboat, baby. I'm getting out of here. But remember in the movie The Titanic, how you felt about those people, the rich people who got into the boats that were half full and they left, and you're saying under your breath, go back, take those people in. And they're saying to themselves, we can't risk that they may tip us over. No, we got to get rid of this lifeboat ethic, okay? Everybody's in the boat. There's one race, the human race. We are all born equal. That's in our founding documents. If anybody in the world has no intellectual excuse for solidarity with the poor, it's us. Because our founding documents were the first government to establish, enshrined in the basic constitutional documents, that all people are created equal and have as part of themselves these inalienable rights, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And you could, you know, you could reword them to say ecological sanity and social justice or whatever if you want to update the language, but it's basically the same thing. So what we have is we're in the early stages of a transition, a paradigm shift from money values, violence, God is on our side, to life values, human rights and the environment, nonviolence, and God doesn't take sides. God doesn't take sides in intra-species conflicts, right? If you got red ants and black ants fighting, I think God's on one side. God is on our 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 side. If you heard that conversation from those ants, you'd go, wow, you ants are stupid. God's not going to intervene in that. So we got a Bin Laden saying, oh, well, the innocent people we killed are infidels, so that's okay. And actually, the Arabic word for that is the word in South Africa that the whites used against blacks, kafir, 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 unbeliever. It means nigger, basically, in the South African context. Okay, so he's saying they're just a bunch of niggers, you know. And then Bush and the people defending the policy say, well, the innocent people we kill in Afghanistan are collateral damage. But it's a niggerization again. Cornel West has a great rap on this. He says, we've all been niggerized now. September 11 niggerized us all. Because what it says is, we don't care. We don't care you're innocent. No, we're just going to kill you. So now we know how it feels.